Never done.
Yeah.
Speaking of waiting, do you want to get on the scale while we're doing this, Eric?
Oh.
We don't have to make it a big deal.
You had 2 weeks off. You were, you know, in the sun probably.
Oh, 2 weeks of vacation. Oh, boy, that's not good.
Take the headphones off. That's going to be at least a pound, you silly goose.
I've never seen Sam get in here so fast.
Oh, hey, Sam loves it.
You got to be wearing that. You're always wearing that.
They're actually making him put back his what is that?
Blackberry.
They pay attention to exactly what he has on his person.
Does he have his shoes on usually?
Yeah.
Okay.
Look, they ran in. They got their notepad with the last weight and everything.
And your eye drops.
Your eye drops.
Ew. I bet you he lost a few pounds.
He definitely lost
pounds. Nope.
Well,
I say he gained two more.
He's going to the tracksuit, though.
I think what?
I had 223. I had 222. It's
223.
223.4. Who wins?
How much you gain?
You had 222. I had 224.6.
How much did he gain?
He gained
two more pounds.
Did you?
Yep.
I said 2 pounds.
Oh.
Yeah, I see it in the neck.
Yep. Yeah. The first place it shows up on E-Rock. Yeah.
How tall are you?
Yeah.
5'11".
Jesus.
What?
Really?
You trying to squeeze an inch on me somewhere?
He looks like he's 5'5".
Of course he does. I didn't know they stack shit that high.
Oh, God. And then he just goes, man.
Yeah, well.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, E-Rock. I do try to protect you from time to time.
I wasn't even goofing on him. I thought he looked good. I think he slipped out of here.
I think it's hilarious that these guys secretly behind the scenes are all figuring out.
Oh, they're betting.
They're betting on the weight whenever it happens.
Are you at your heaviest right now?
Yeah.
You're heavier than you've ever been.
Yeah.
What are you? Jesus Christ. Remember when you ate fucking mayo sandwiches with the bacon and everything else? What did you switch to?
Mustard.
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 That's fat-free.
He puts it on cake. I would like some mustard cake.
E-Rock, you've been with us almost...
I'm just trying to figure this out. This makes no sense.
He's been with us almost 3 years.
The day that, I guess, I grossed Jimmy and you out with the mayonnaise packets.
Yeah.
I was under 200 at the time. Yeah, I was.
Crazy. But you would come in here every fucking day with that bacon and shit sandwich, whatever it was.
BLT.
And eat that.
I say, go back to that. I know what's going on.
What?
Liquid diarrhea after eating.
Oh, God.
It's not staying in his system
long enough for him to digest it.
The greasy bacon, the mayo, probably the lettuce that's a little old.
The underside of the toilet looks like a fucking semi just went by it in a rainstorm. Old shit splatters fucking nagel.
What are you eating now that is fatter than fucking bacon and shit? Like, what are you eating that you think has made you put on more weight?
Let's do this faster. What aren't you?
I honestly really don't. It's a lot of meat still. Probably bread.
Yeah.
On top of that.
Yeah, bread's evil.
How much bread? Yeah. What do you have? Like
bread's
like
meat?
Have it with toast or whatever with breakfast. And then
white
sandwich
bread
at lunch.
Toast?
Rye toast.
Oh, it's bad.
Yeah, but what else are you having for breakfast with this toast?
Yeah,
cheese omelet.
Just toast and fucking water.
Usually apple, banana, and that light and lively yogurt. It's pretty much what Jim eats.
Oh, an apple, a banana, and light and lively, and some toast. Okay, that ain't making you the heaviest you've ever been.
No, today was a little different. Today was the egg and cheese on the toast.
Mm-hmm.
All I ever see you eating is those sandwiches. I always see you eating sandwiches that have packets all about. Just little
packets.
Condiments that have been deliciously squeezed onto the sandwich for flavor enhancement.
He needs condiments.
I would like some condiments, please. Some flavorful additives.
Deli sandwiches, evil.
High sodium.
Well, it's usually turkey and Swiss, pretty much.
But deli meat.
Yeah, it's bad. I was going to have some turkey, and I decided no turkey.
They give you a pound of cheese.
Yep. Yeah.
A pound of cheese, son.
Cheese on there, a lot of mayo.
Danny, what's up?
What's up, Danny?
Danny has to come in.
Well, I'm saying that's what Eric has for breakfast, but then I see him eating lunch all the time, and he's always got some giant... I catch you all the time. You got some giant 14-inch roast beef hero.
Oh, is that what you're having?
That was actually the... day or two before we went on vacation, I actually had roast beef.
Uh-huh.
But,
and then the day before that, and the day before that.
Yeah, exactly.
Bullshit.
What happened? You went to market,
stuff.
And you had to have some roast beef, and then you wheezed all the way home.
That hurts.
Oh, fucking A.
See, how is it not line of the day every time?
Oh, it's hysterical.
We're W-H-E-E-Z-E-D, sweetie.
We are a little worried, though. You went to the tracksuit look.
Wait, I didn't
it is fashionable, but no, I'm pissing. Oh. Wee-wee-wee all the way home. But,
yeah. I didn't say wee-wee-wee, though.
This right. Little piggy roast beef.
All right,
what did you say?
Wee-wee-weezed.
Oh, no, E-Rock, don't leave.
You did go to the tracksuit look, though.
Yeah. Just the jacket.
Oh, of course. Okay. The pants are next, though, let's be honest.
Exactly.
Go with the Joey Buttafuoco pants after a while, no?
Hey, you hear the rumor about Joey and
A-Rock? Aren't being fair. We moved on to Danny, and the pad data still says fat sex bagel.
Sorry. Danny, let me
change that immediately.
Change it to drunk Danny.
You guys suck.
Fat sex bagel.
We left that 10 minutes ago.
We went to drunk Danny. Could have been on the pad for 10 minutes.
That's right.
But and now it's not even going to get 3 seconds time on there.
Right. Fat sex bagel.
Poor you.
You almost said poor fat.
You almost said, yeah, you were ready to say poor fat sex bagel.
I'm trying to, like, bring him into the circle.
Bring him what?
His shape, like, just
bring him into the circle.
I'm just trying not to be as mean to him.
Bring him to the fucking mooring lines. Jesus Christ.
I happen to like Eric very much. I'm just concerned. Due to this path to obesity he's taking, that's all. I mean, I'm not trying to disrespect the kid. He's cute. He's got a cute face, frog-like neck.
I just can't believe he's the heaviest he's been when he's supposed to be eating better. We all voiced our concern when he went and his cholesterol was too high or something and said, stop eating the fucking bacon.
I think if we complimented E-Rock, he would maybe.
No, it's tough love. No, you don't compliment people. It's tough love.
How light was E-Rock in the 3 years that we've known him?
Well, when was he as lightest? Pull out the fucking graphs you guys make on E-Rock.
Is there a photo? Pictures of him from last year? Pictures of him from 2 years ago? Yeah, you might see it in the face.
No, roughly.
Well, since we've been keeping track, on January 25th, February 1st, Eric weighed 210.4 pounds.
All right, he's up to 224. But
he put on 14 pounds since February? He put on...
Yes.
You know how hard that is to do?
And casual, you know.
It's 3 months! Yes.
Come back in, Eric.
Oh, Eric. Oh, Eric.
That's 5 pounds.
Look, he just winced.
Basically.
He winced and got out of his chair.
E-Rock, be honest.
It hurt.
This is all I want to know. You've been around for 3 years, just under 3 years. What was your lightest? We know your heaviest is right now at 224.
Yes.
Yeah.
What was your lightest? Be honest.
Anywhere between 190 to 193, right in there. That's pretty much.
You've gained around that 34 pounds. 30 some odd pounds. Pounds since, pounds.
You came aboard?
Where did that come from?
Probably.
Pounds.
Yeah.
Mm. Wow. What's the problem?
What's the matter? What are you covering up?
Yeah.
What are you covering up?
What are you doing? You got that hot girlfriend of yours. You got
Yeah. What are you trying to do? Make her go away?
What are you doing?
You're a pretty girl.
What's going on?
I don't exercise enough.
Enough?
I like how he said that. Like, I don't exercise enough.
What am I going to do? Lie?
No.
That's a great lie.
Down.
Yeah. Wait a minute.
All disgusted with himself. I don't exercise
enough. He was mad saying that.
You sound like John Candy.
You were angry saying that.
And you said enough. Like there's some to make. Like, remove the enough. Too.
What kind of exercise do you do?
Being forced to. Yes.
What do you do? Exercise-wise.
Yeah. Not a whole lot. Other treadmill and some free weights. That's it.
When?
Frequency.
I'm up to 2 times a week now.
Doing what?
From nothing.
He's laughing.
He's not.
What kind of weight are you doing?
No, I am.
Are you trying to say you gained muscle?
Do you put a sandwich at the end of the treadmill, and then when you reach it, it's time to stop?
No, he says wait. It's W-A-I-T. And they say you want to exercise, he says wait.
Free weight. He's free to wait.
Jesus.
Oh, E-Rock.
I don't exercise enough.
We just care.
Why don't you swim walk?
Just Jimmy swim walks. He could teach you.
Yeah, why is the pad day to say fat sex bagel again?
You're ruthless.
Why do you look so confused? It's a salad. Oh, fuck.
I don't know what's in that. I don't want to break it.
No, no, it's a very expensive. Yeah, Eric, it's just, you might look at it like we're goofing on you stuff, but it is out of, you know, caring. We don't want you to.
How many push-ups can you do right now?
Have health problems?
While still breathing, probably almost 20.
20? Let's see it.
Boys, you ready to bet?
Well, you know what? Hold on.
All right, let's bet.
You know what? Wait a minute. Yeah. E-Rock was a lot tougher than everybody thought when he had that fucking stuff on his balls. Everybody, he was a lot tougher than everybody. I want to see.
A little different than having shit on your balls.
Believe me, he's a disaster. No disrespect. But maybe we could get one. Not Stan, because Stan's a fucking cock monolith. But maybe we could get one of these guys to do push-ups against E-Rock, and not Steve, because he obviously exercises a lot.
Yes.
But a guy who doesn't, maybe, you know, because I think E-Rock could probably do a little better than people think. How about Travis or Sam?
Travis with his little skinny
with
arms.
Danny.
How about you get to pick? How about you get to pick one of those three guys?
Well, maybe don't forget Danny, and don't forget, you can't picture, you can't use fucking
Sam.
Jupiter version of me in the back.
Oh,
Tony.
Fuck.
He looks like me squared. We're both looking at what could happen if we made other decisions.
How much does he weigh? Motherfucker, man. You're big.
He's a big boy.
That's scaling. Look at E-Rock's waving him in like, come on, get in here.
Yeah, he doesn't even want to come in.
No, it's okay. It's 350, Eric.
Oh, he was 350.
He's 350?
Yeah, somewhere around there. Okay, E-Rock, what about some push-ups, you think?
You want to out-push up one of these guys?
I'll try Travis.
Oh,
Travis.
Travis is light, though.
Yeah. Travis is light, but...
I don't have a Danny.
Oh, I'd have picked Danny in a second.
Because he smoked like an animal,
yeah,
and his
I know.
Liver weighs fucking... Danny's liver, it looks like an anvil in a fucking Wile E. Coyote moment.
All three, then.
His liver's going to weigh him down. Wait, now you're saying you can beat all three?
Oh, wow.
No, I mean Danny, Travis, and me.
At the same time.
Okay,
try that then.
Why not?
Yeah,
I could jerk off
fucking
watching
each
that.
Other.
Yeah, a bunch of men doing push-ups over my mouth.
I'm about to do it outside.
How are we going to do this? Yeah, they got to do it outside.
But they got to be able to see it.
Oh, we'll be able to see it.
Yeah.
By that blue line.
What?
They're always picking on E-Rock. I want to see. Again, Stan's a worker outer.
Yeah.
Steve's a workouter, but Stan's a fucking, like, martial artist.
Yeah, Stan.
Stan's a problem.
Stan could...
Yeah, Stan's a fucking...
Stan could hurt.
Stan's tall, too, so he could put that foot up the side of your head
that. He's a rage-repressed fucking creep.
Yeah. I bet when that comes out, it's so fucking ugly and out of character, it would scare the shit out of you.
To avoid beating women, he probably pinches himself hard.
Yeah, he's got pinch marks all over his arms.
I get the mic. All right. Well, there's one out there. The wired one.
Right, I could see.
Hey, can you, anyway.
Just make sure they're all on me. Jimmy, you're in my...
Oh,
no.
Hon. Hey, is this on? Okay, is this on?
It's on, I think.
Turn me up. I'm deaf. Get him a wireless.
Oh, Danny's working his arms.
Here's how you know Danny's finished.
Yeah.
He's doing the crisscross arms, like loosening my arms up.
Yeah, yeah. He's finished. He's already tired.
He's doing calisthenics.
Jack LaLanne.
All right, you guys can see from...
Jack LaAss.
What are the rules? What are the rules?
You guys do them at the same time.
Yep.
Same.
All right. Who's counting? It's...
Sam.
You're going to count all of them? Might
now,
be tough.
Now, look. You got to do authentic push-ups.
Steve, you count E-Rock's push-ups.
Dude,
Sam.
We can't have people fucking up with push-ups either and doing pussy versions.
How about this? You get Poe to count, Sam, and Steve. Each will count one person.
Right.
Are we doing it until they got dead arms or time limit?
Until they stop.
Dead arms?
Right. Yeah, until you can't go any longer.
All right, cool.
That's it.
And you're right. Clapping.
Wait, so if they go to dead arms, why don't we just do one at a time?
Okay.
And then E-Rock's last.
Yeah. Oh, and E-Rock's got a beat. Oh, okay. That's a good idea.
So you go until you can't push up anymore, okay?
Push up till you can't push up no more.
And then E-Rock is last, and we'll see if he can beat
out. If he can beat out. That's good. I like it.
Because then we can focus on each athlete.
Yes. Each athlete.
We should get their backstory and, you know, the
fucking Special Olympics.
What they had to overcome.
Because this abuse should be spread out a little bit today.
Like Travis had to fucking emigrate here from another country in a box of swizzle sticks.
Huh?
Confirm what's a push-up.
What are you guys
Yeah, what's a push-up? Are we going chest has to hit the floor, right?
Yeah, I think Paul's going to demonstrate in a suit. All right.
Chest just touches the floor.
All right.
What? Wait, come here. We got a mic.
Yeah, we need
Travis
a mic over there.
Travis had something that made everyone laugh out there. If your chest has to hit the floor, Eric's is going to hit it a lot quicker than ours.
Oh, he's implying that Eric's unsightly tits, which are dangling in a humiliating fashion.
This is so horrible.
Utters, good point, Dan.
All right.
Oh.
E-Rock, we're giving you a chance to shut these guys up, man.
I'm pulling for Eric.
This is
schoolyard bullying.
You'll have slight bragging rights.
Yeah, if you do more push-ups, you'll have a big bragging rights.
Yep, true.
Look at Danny. Danny's stretching. He's already sweating Guinness.
Danny's nervous.
Danny is sitting to save his energy. You're finished, Dan.
Danny. All right, who wants to go first?
Oh, shit.
Travis?
All right. Travis will do push-ups Travis. Until he can't do any more
Travis,
push-ups.
Very slender.
Yes.
Yeah. Hey, we'll...
Shoulder width.
All right, this is the perfect.
Yeah.
Paul, right, the only yourself. Thing we want from you, because you have a tendency of wrecking bits.
I hit a nerve.
if he's really failing with the push-ups, you just go, you know, down a little. Yeah, but don't. We'll have Sam count. Yeah,
we don't need, like, drill instructor shit.
If there's one or two lame push-ups, then we'll let it go.
Yeah, let it go, but, you know.
All right, here we go. Travis.
Travis in position. There's one, two.
Two, this kid's good.
Three.
Oh, he's not even tired yet.
Four.
A thumbs up from Poe, by the way.
Five. Six, seven.
Oh.
Eight. Uh-oh.
He's got a brown sweatshirt on, little new, but he's pushing up 3 pounds.
11. Don't make him laugh. Just
fuck him as well.
Well, be fair.
Grasshopper weight.
13.
His body's 14. Moving really weird for push-ups, man.
Yeah, it is.
16.
Stop fucking the ground.
16.
Yeah, that's exactly. 17.
I think Travis is
Let
a good
go.
Fuck.
18.
Look at him.
19. Oh, don't make him laugh.
I know.
20. It's starting to strain a little.
Hey, is it weird pushing back without a gentleman behind
22,
you?
22. 23.
All right,
24. Wow. 24. 24. Wow,
no,
Travis.
20. He didn't get 25 up.
He went down on 24.
I'm here to watch you guys.
Yeah.
I want E-Rock to have a fair shot at this.
Fair shot. He's fucking out, man. Travis is the champ.
It wasn't even close to a 25th push-up, and Sam's like, it's 25.
No, he was on the ground. He went 24 up and then down, and that was it.
All right, 24 for Travis. Danny's up next.
You can't do half a push-up. It's called laying down on your stomach.
Or how about as many push-ups as they do Eric has to do with chubby bunny marshmallows?
Go ahead, Danny.
All right, Danny.
Oh, this is not going to be pretty. One, and he's out.
Two. He's starting out fast.
Three.
Four.
Thumbs up from Poe.
Five.
Push-ups look good.
He's already tired.
Seven. Eight.
Now he's going to have no problem.
Nine.
Yes, he will.
He's got good form.
11. He does have bigger arms. 13. 14.
He's tired.
15. 16.
He just wants to beat that little
17,
fairy.
18. 19. 20.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. He's
tired.
21.
22. Hurry up, you girl.
23. 24.
One more.
One more.
25.
26.
26.
You look like a newborn fawn.
That's it. We can't have him wait too long in between.
Yeah, why don't you just take a nap and come back, shit face?
28. Can't rest too much.
How long are we leaving to rest?
Hey, take 20 and... Fucking start again. 29.
Push. Oh, no. He's down. 29.
He did 29, but we got to have a time limit between those weights.
Yeah.
He
that
can't
was pretty
just
impressive.
Stay up there and wait.
I know. He's got a connecting flight. He's in the President's Club lounging.
He's holding his heart.
All right, this is going to be awful.
Oh, Jesus.
You know how Eric's done because he's
all
got...
All right, hold on.
Eric, that's not how you start with push-ups.
Wait a minute. Hold on. I can't watch this.
To get into position.
Holy shit.
Eric, Eric fucking.
Old fatso.
He wormed into position. He just his arms and his knees, and he fucking just wormed onto the ground.
Jesus Christ.
Oh no.
Oh.
What is that, Private Pile? Sir, Jelly Donuts.
All right, here we go. E-Rock's going.
That hat's on backwards.
One.
Oh my God.
Two.
So
three. Four.
He's finished.
Five. Six. Seven.
He just wants to do 10 so he can get laid again.
9.
He will never make it to 24.
10. The 11.
He'll never make it.
12.
Oh, fuck.
13. He'll never make it. I guarantee it.
14. He's done. 15.
I'm just going to call it.
Oh, E-Rod. You humiliated yourself. You humiliated me. Had my money on you.
Oh, God.
I can't even look at him.
Oh, no.
Barely 15.
Wow.
Open your mouth. They're paying for it. You eat it.
Oh, you rock.
Oh, God.
I thought you said you were working out with weights.
No, just not hard enough.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Eric.
Well, wow.
Eric.
I'm just going to call it.
You knew he was in trouble when he was getting into position. He looked like he needed a medical alert button. Looked like the old lady going down the steps.
I would bet money that he's never done a push-up before. He had no clue to how you even start.
Not since gym class.
When was the last time you did a push-up?
Well, it's been a while.
Yeah, he's kind of smiling like, yeah.
It's been a while.
Yeah, it's been a while.
Most people start in the up position. He started completely flat
in the down position.
Well, because he was hoping just a push-up would count as one.
Right.
Yeah.
All right, we got to take a break. Very good.
All right.
Give you a chance, E-Rock. You failed. If you would have won the push-up contest,
yeah,
you
would have shut everyone
for a day or two.
What does the pad data say?
You don't want to know.
What does it say?
Fat sex bagel again.
Oh, it still says fat sex bagel. You fucking guys.
All right, listen.
That's so cruel.
We're going to go to break with this because we want to get this little thing going. We're thinking about a remix contest. We haven't done this in a while. We got the Alec Baldwin audio.
Yep.
That everyone has heard and loved. And now we got the David Hasselhoff audio that we gave you guys yesterday.
Drunken Hasselhoff.
Danny has started the thing. The remix contest. We want the listeners to jump on board and send in some unique remixes. But this is Danny's submission. It's Alec talking to David Hasselhoff on the phone.
Hey, I want to tell you something, okay? Because, again, it's 10:30 here in New York on a Wednesday. And once again, I made an ass of myself trying to get to a phone to call you at a specific time.
Who said?
When the time comes for me to make the phone call, I stop whatever I'm doing, and I go when I make that phone call.
You aren't good in your life.
I want you to know something, okay? I'm tired of playing this game with you.
I'll have you.
You have insulted me for the last time.
No, I don't.
You have humiliated me for the last time with this phone.
I'm going to stop. I'll be fine.
And when I come out there next week, I'm going to fly out there for the day. Just to straighten you out.
This is a mess.
I'm going to let you know just how disappointed in you I am and how angry I am with you that you've done this to me again.
I'm bullshit.
I am going to get on a plane, and I'm going to come out there for the day, and I'm going to straighten your ass out when I see you. Do you understand me? So you better be ready Friday, the 20th, to meet with me about what a rude little pig you really are.
I love you, alive.
You are a rude, thoughtless little pig, okay?
What?
It's E-Rock Radio.
I love E-Rock.
We love E-Rock Radio.
E-Rock? What's that?
E-Rock Radio.
Yeah, I like them.
It's hot.
It's cool.
E-Rock.
E-Rock?
E-Rock Radio.
He's evil.
He's a bad guy.
He's not true to himself, and he's just ugly, and his nose is falling off.
I don't love it.
He's an asshole.
Eric Nagel is this, like, he's this bisexual, incompetent radio guy, believe it or not.
I don't like listening to him, and he's not really that smart.
E-Rock can go fuck himself.
By the way, can I throw out a big thank you to my friend of Asian descent, Yoshi, for sending me a bat that was signed to me by Jason Giambi, the one Yankee I really love.
I watched you open that. I had no clue. It's a bat that's been used.
Game used, yep.
Yeah, game used, and it's got his little signature. And it says, to Jim, love your stuff.
Jason Giambi?
Well, Yoshi probably told him I'm the porn supplier. I don't think Giambi knows who I am.
Oh, okay.
But whatever it is.
Because I would be a little annoyed if he knew what you did and were a comedian and maybe saw you on TV or something.
Oh, yeah, it's common with me, but maybe it was, maybe Yoshi sent him something. Who knows? Maybe Yoshi said, Lucky Louie. Yoshi just throws out your credits when he introduces you. Hey, this is Jim Norton, Opie Anthony, Lucky Louie, Comedy Central, until they finally go, oh,
all right, shut up. Love your stuff.
Right, all right, I'll sign.
Jason Giambi, here's the bat. Yeah. Now leave before I put it over your head. All right. That's a good one, though, man.
We got to get Russell Peters on the show. Do you know who Russell Peters is? He is literally one of the biggest comics in the world. He's not as big.
I don't know that name.
He's just he sells out in Canada, the U.S., and Singapore. The guy fucking sells out 5,000 seats everywhere he goes.
Well, we certainly don't want him then.
But
then how come I don't know the name?
He's a lot of it's internet. He's an Indian guy, and he's very well known. He has a massive fucking face. He's huge in Canada too. Huge.
Yeah.
He's big here. But just for all, you know, there's so many guys
Canada.
Here.
Canada.
Yeah. Well, no, Canada. But we all know, no disrespect, Canada. But, you know, you're not us.
Canada.
You're North Mexico.
they stand on guard for thee, though.
Yeah.
Thank you for that. Whatever that means.
Hey, Mancow. Yeah, wow.
Did he really say that about the Thea thing?
Mancow discusses the state of radio, because everyone's discussing the state of radio, and that's what we do every day. So this is of some interest. And he did this on Fox and Friends, I guess.
Of course, because he doesn't have any radio shows to do it from.
And he started the interview, because he's so terrific, with tape over his mouth, because, you know.
To hold the cum in?
Fucking ass. Yeah, that is so hack when you...
Why? Because it has a nutritional value?
I don't know why. It conjures up a fun image.
Do you know what's so disgusting about that? Is that somebody would not only have cum in their mouth, but that they wouldn't swallow it yet. Yet. The idea of it leaking out is so uncomfortable. Tape has to be put there because they want to enjoy the flavor.
Yeah. I like the way you put everything in context like that.
You want to chew down the chunks before you swallow.
Oh, Jesus, Jimmy.
The tape. Well, Mancow discusses the state of radio, and he's a douchebag.
Yes, he is.
He's, I guess he's taking our place, is what he's saying, but...
is he?
First this clip.
Mancow, you know, a couple of DJs here in New York City yanked off the air by CBS Radio because they made some inappropriate racist comments. Oh, I see what you're doing right there. Are you afraid to talk on the radio? They're the offenders right there.
See, they go to him, and they asked him a really good question, and so he had tape over.
I gotta be wacky.
You're doing right there. Are you afraid to talk on the radio? They're the offenders right there.
Look, first of all, I want to say JB and Elvis are competition. I'm his competition. I want all of them to go away. But the fact is, unless you're doing hip-hop radio or rap, you're in trouble all the time. There really is a double standard.
I want them all to go away.
Go away.
To go away. That's all competition.
That's the only way he'll get real radio stations is if we all go away.
Yeah, everyone goes away, then maybe he'll be on a real station somewhere.
Is Howard Stern available? No, he's on satellite. Opie and Anthony available? No, CBS got rid of them recently. Ron and Fez? No, they just got kicked off the radio. JV and Elvis? No. And they'll have to go down a whole list.
Finally got fired? Yes, Slappy and Wappy got fired, too.
How about Rob, Arnie, and Dawn?
No, we don't trust that Arnie. He's a loose cannon.
Who else we got? Well, there's this Mancow.
That's the only way he's going to get real radio stations is if we all go away.
Boy, are these lawyers getting some fucking advertisement today.
They don't even...
Every 2 seconds, that phone number's up there. Oh, there she is.
Ann Coulter, if she was a man chick.
She looks a little better than she does.
She has a hose up her asshole. What a sucked-in face she has. Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Dude, these guys are on TV being interviewed now. Life short. We did this over at the other joint, the billboard advertising divorce with a really hot chick showing a lot of cleavage. And they're showing the number.
Yeah, every time the phone number is being shown.
They're not cubing out the number.
It's a commercial.
brilliant.
It's a fucking commercial for their law firm playing all day long on all the news channels.
Brilliant for these
guys.
Yep. Great marketing. We got to do something like that.
Yeah, how?
Life's short.
What do we
divorce.
Do?
All right.
Here's Man Cow.
Ah. Well, Man Cow, are you being talked to every day? Don't go over the line. You know, that'll be it. We can't even stand by you. We can't save you.
Here's the deal, Brian. I don't go over the line. I know where the line is. And it's some of these shows, these lesser shows that are trying to get attention. They don't have ratings, and they'll do whatever it takes to get attention. And when you do that, you find yourself in trouble.
He is the biggest douchebag in this
business. Oh, my wait a minute. God.
Look, we have problems. We have problems with radio show hosts, but when it comes to douchebags, you are listening to the biggest one in the entire fucking business. He made his life getting attention by doing outrageous shit.
Yeah.
So does that mean you never had talent in this business, you dope? And we all know where the line is, but this is a whole different ball game now.
He is, you're right, the worst radio personality out there. Worse than Howard, as far as, you know, our wars go with radio people or our hatred for other personalities. I'd sooner have Howard come over for dinner than even spit on fucking Man Cow to get that close to him. This guy,
you know what?
Is a dickbag, lying fucking sack of shit. Well, he's a liar.
Here's the difference, too. You know, obviously we have our problems with Howard, but at least he bases a lot of his stuff on real facts. You know, he's...
Sometimes.
He skews him here and there. This fucking guy, man, dude...
Constant liar.
Just completely just ignores facts and lies through his teeth.
One thing you can't argue is Howard's success. The guy's had success in his career. Stop.
Dude, guys got to be pulling in $100,000, $125,000 a year.
Perhaps more than that, Jim. This is how you do a diamond push-up, gentlemen.
Oh, yeah.
The bit's Please. Over. Jesus.
No, it's not out there.
Where's Sam? Dude,
when the bits end on the air, it continues out in the hallway.
That was impressive, but can you do a diamond push-up?
Sam goes, the bit's
Sam's
over.
Just like, the bit's over. I wasn't challenged. I wasn't challenged. The bit's over.
Mr. Poe just stopped calling me King Sam maybe 2 weeks ago.
Why did he call you King Sam?
Remember when we did the Sam's Family Tree bit two years ago?
2 years?
Dude, I didn't even know what King Sam meant.
Two years ago. That's great. No. You were Alexander the Great, right, or something?
Yeah.
Yeah, we didn't even mention it when the movie Alexander came out.
We forgot.
It was that long ago. Holy fuck.
I thought King Sam was a tuna.
No, we were just talking about your, you know.
What's wrong, Sam?
Oh, nothing's wrong. Are you kidding me? Poe, me have a good time.
Sam, what happened after the push-up contest?
Oh, well, Poe was asking me, why wasn't I in the contest?
Yeah.
I wasn't challenged.
Oh, he wasn't challenged.
You know, E-Rock wanted to take on Danny and Travis this time, and he needed an official,
right.
An unbiased source to count, which is why I was there.
But now Poe is challenging you and saying, you know, well, let me see what you can do.
Well, yeah, I made a motion like, oh, yeah, I could do push-ups doing this, and then my hands were close together. He said, oh, diamond push-ups.
Diamond push-ups. Now, those are different?
Yes, they are.
And it's when your
That's
hands
when
are
you put
like
your two pointer fingers and your thumbs together.
That's right.
And it makes a diamond.
The push-ups of the Jews.
Well, my sloppy pussy comments. Not gonna,
was, yeah,
not
I
do as well as
say, like,
I was going to go with sloppy pussy, but.
I don't know, Sammy Hagar. Hold on. It's when you put your fingers
floppies.
Together. Sloppy floppies. And then you do it like that? So
yes.
You're like on, wow, that's got to be hard.
It's very difficult.
Why is that harder? Let me see. Leverage. Yeah.
Yeah.
And yeah, he said, I'll bet you couldn't do 15. And I said, sure I could, because I wasn't actually going to have to do them.
So you might as well just say you can do them.
Yeah, I mean, and then he said, do 15 right now. Me versus you though, for lunch. I guess you're saying you bet lunch on it, right?
Sure, why
yeah.
not?
And I was trying to tell him it's not gym class. I was working for a radio show.
Fucking Sam is the biggest smartass walking around this fucking place.
Because he knows
he's so unassuming.
He knows he can't get hit. I know the game.
He is so unassuming and such a smartass fuck. Oh, this is his gym class. I work for a radio show. Oh, fuck.
What did you used to do when people, like big kids, walked by you?
Didn't used to.
Oh, in high school?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I hung out with big kids, and I would throw myself against lockers when there were big crowds, and then fall on the floor and cry because the lockers were...
make a lot of noise.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then you just fall on the floor and cry just out of nowhere, and that way every girl or sympathetic guy would check to make sure you're okay and call the big guy an asshole.
Do you know if you were a woman, you'd smother your own infants?
I don't know.
Throw yourself against the locker. That's a pretty good gag. I'll give you that one.
Yeah.
How many push-ups do you think you could do?
I don't know. Danny was asking me. I think I could stay in there with Danny and Travis.
You think you could? Yeah. Yeah. Don't worry. Not even going to ask you. Yeah. I really don't care.
I'd rather beat Eric.
Yeah, you could beat Eric, though, right?
Yeah.
Anyone could.
Exactly. All Christopher Reeve beat Eric 2 weeks before he died. See how I make him topical again? So, Paul, what was your point with young Sam?
Well, the only reason why I did that is I was walking by, and he was sitting down in his chair, and he was bragging that he could have done the push-ups, and he was pushing his hands back and forth really fast.
Ah.
And I said, well, why don't you try it? And then he started talking. He said he could... do it with no problem.
No, yeah, no problem. But I had to answer phones. I had to do the worst of the week. You know, I got a lot of responsibility.
You're a busy guy. Yeah,
I got a lot of responsibility.
You're saying that he doesn't, right? I heard.
I'm just saying I got a lot of responsibilities.
I picked up on that.
I don't have time for push-ups.
He basically said, because I don't know how smart you are, that you don't have as much responsibility as he does around here.
That's not what I said.
I heard.
I know exactly what he said. Go ahead. Come on. Why don't you do 15 right now? No. Why don't you do 15?
You're being shallow.
Diamond push-ups, 15. Ooh. If you do diamond push-ups, 15 of them, I will buy you lunch.
Ooh. Look. Make that bet with Eric and fucking take out another mortgage.
You know, I got I got money for lunch. Smart. I got to do some stuff for work. Wow. I don't.
Diamond push-ups are tough.
I'm doing them sitting and it hurts.
Yeah.
I don't know how you do it that way.
Paul, you want to show us a couple? Give me an example. I want to see what.
Yeah, 15 diamond push-ups, baby.
You don't have to do 15. I can do it all day. I just want to see what they look like as done by. A man that can actually do that.
That's it. There you go.
Wow.
Very good.
That does look difficult.
Paul is in good shape.
He's in some shape.
I don't know why I'm saying that about a black belt like it's a shock.
Right, yeah.
So go ahead, Sam.
No, I'm just saying good job, man.
He gives him the thumbs up, yeah. The big thumbs up.
Sam, I didn't eat lunch. Come on.
Ooh.
I didn't eat lunch either. It's like 11:30.
Ooh, shit.
I love this.
I've been working.
Thumb wrestle him. You'll kick his ass.
Yeah, that's right. I got a big thumb.
He's got big thumbs.
All right, I guess you're not going to
do like
it.
I feel like this is high school. Like,
oh, I know.
Like, Sam can't compete with Paul. Sam can kick his ass.
Oh, what's Jimmy doing?
Diamond push-ups, yeah.
Diamond push-ups.
All right, he did 5.
He's definitely harder than regular. I could have done a few more.
Very good.
Could have done a couple of more.
Yeah, I might get this.
One-handed. Can you do the one-armed Jack Palance push-up?
I do the one-armed the cubic zirconia.
Oh, hold on.
All right, so no. I'll clear up the push-up bit, but apparently everybody wants dick jokes.
All right. Are we all clear now? You're the toughest man in the room. You're good with that?
No.
All right.
All right. Thank you, gentlemen.
You're tougher than me.
But carry on the controversy outside.
The shit that goes on while we're trying to do a radio show.
It's just hysterical.
It's the show within the show.
Yep.
Why? What happened?
Sweat.
Ew, what? Why are you sweating?
He did diamond push-ups.
Why are you paying it to me?
I just wanted to show you.
Oh. Jesus. I'm doing push-ups. Fucking the little kid from Sixth Sense should be staring at the table after he touches it. Way to mumble that out with lettuce in my mouth.
It's evaporating.
Terrell for everybody. What are you laughing at, Mars?
He just stands right there. Are you done with him?
We have been done with him.
There we go. He's finally leaving.
Not too smart.
Po.
Oh, Jesus.
All right. And
any more fake gem jokes you want to throw out there, Jim?
And then
isn't that funny? That joke wasn't a gem.
And finally, yeah.
Right. I'll give myself a little crash-a-rooney.
Finally, Man Cow adds us to his.
That's right. We were talking about this
on
douchebag
the state of radio.
Would these guys still be on the air had Imus not gotten it a couple weeks ago?
Well, that station in New York has a lot of problems right now. I mean, Dan Mason is the new head of CBS. I think there's a new sheriff in town. I think Opie and Anthony are gone. They say they're on their vacation. I think they're back to satellite. Imus is gone. Man. So you got a bunch of stations in the CBS cluster that have lost a lot of programming. I think you're going to see a change. So, and don't be surprised if you see me on.
So really, Nick, how are you close to cutting a deal?
Well, we're on a few IMA stations right now, and I think we could work out a deal.
Right. Wow, good luck with that.
Oh, our old buddy, sure, he's becoming a big star now. He's going to forget about us. Mancow, thanks very much. Have a nice weekend.
Shut the fuck up, you dumb cock-sucking dick fuck. What an asshole. What? The whole collection of them. The guy that was talking, the cunt that was talking, and Mancow. All of them fucking dick fucks. Oh, that man has a liar. Close to cutting a deal. And you can just hear the lie. You can hear that lying in his voice. He's trying to come up with something. Try to come up with something.
And how gullible is the guy that's asking the question?
Oh, stop it. Enough. He's not close to cutting shit. I supposedly on a vacation, but they're gone. Are we? Where did we go the past 2 days, Mancow? I'll tell you where. Radio stations that were being listened to. Not like you fucking dickbag. God, do I hate that. Oh, do I hate him. I hate him.
E-Rock is... What, E-Rock?
Fat? Oh, sorry, I thought...
You may hate...
Oh, come on, E-Rock.
What the fudge?
I'm just toying with you.
Exactly.
You want me to sign this?
Leave Augustus Nagel alone.
Augustus Nagel?
Oh, sorry. Oh, dude, I got his press press package.
Yeah.
It's a big picture of him in a gorilla suit because he's the, what is it called? The 800-pound gorilla in the room?
That no one wants to talk about.
Is he? Yeah, no one wants to talk about him, that's for sure.
And it says, Mancow welcomes new affiliates. So this is going out to everybody. This is the big get. San Francisco on AM 860, KTRB.
Ooh.
Houston, and then in parentheses, announcement embargoed until March 31st.
Announcement, and my announcement's been embargoed. Yeah, there's ships holding it off.
He's heard in Cincinnati, Miami on some small AM, Indianapolis, Atlantic City. Wow.
Atlantic City.
And not Vegas, but Reno.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
That's the big...
that's it, huh?
Wow, that's just as impressive as
the guy is a compulsive liar. He is just the guy couldn't come up with an honest thing. You're close to cutting a deal? Yeah, well, I'm already on some of the IMA stations. Are you?
Are you? Name
are
one.
You?
Name one.
Which ones?
Name one.
And, things are... Nothing. Nothing. No one wants you. You're a fucking... You've turned into a religious fanatic, is what you've done. That's what pretty much what his fans are saying that used to listen to him when he was a shock jock that he likes to say he never was. He's this... Like, he wants to be a political guy, but he throws this, you know, oh, God bless... He throws his religion in there. He doesn't know how to fucking talk politics. So it's just this mishmash of shit that no one wants to pick up and no one wants to listen to.
Well, we got his demo.
Yep.
Is it old?
Nope.
No, this is the one that's with the new show that he's trying to...
This is the one that's being sent out. And believe me, this is being sent out. No one's asking for this.
I am proud to say that I haven't sent out a demo. Ant and I have been working together 12 years. We never sent out a demo.
No.
Never had to send out a demo. Stations just pick us up word of mouth. Back in the day, when I first started radio, yes, that's how you get jobs. You send out demos. E-Rock knows. Most of the guys around here know. You send out your demo. But this stage in your career, you got to send out a demo to get stations? That's not too
good.
He's
sending out a fucking demo. Do you think Howard would have to send out a demo? Do you think Imus, when he does, believe me, he will get back on the air, will have to send out a demo of his material?
Or Than and Sam?
Than and Sam. No demo necessary.
None, no good stuff to make one.
Sam is the star.
I'm glad
glad he stepped out.
I did. fuck. He said, no demo. And I said, there's not enough good stuff to make one.
Oh, shit.
Oh, boy.
That's horrible.
I didn't mean it. What was I going to say? Yeah, they're good. That doesn't help the joke.
You know something? Words that hurt.
Yeah, you're hurting.
Words that hurt, Jimmy.
My apologies.
All right,
I apologize to Fan, who could make short work of me. Samuel, I could tangle with.
All right, what do you got, E-Rock?
The very first track of this...
I'm sorry, I can't stop.
Oh,
that's horrible.
What do you got besides cranky shoes
and high cholesterol?
We're in for a long one. There's going to be 16 runner-up lines of the day.
I'm teasing, man. You know, I don't mean a word of it.
No, I think you got a few more in you.
What do you got?
The first cut of his demo.
Yeah. Oh, there's so many.
I know.
Gravity.
Watch. Yeah. He's going to walk in one day, and Sam and Danny are just going to revolve around him.
At least they haven't changed the pad data yet.
Are you?
It still says Mandu.
Are you calling him a planet?
Well, I'm saying compared to those two, I should have said probably Travis and Sam because they're thinner.
Yeah.
Danny just thinks he's spending because he's drunk.
What do you got? Besides.
Okay. Now, Man Cow, the demo.
That's right.
What do you got besides?
The demo.
The demo.
We want to talk about the demo.
Yes.
The first
What
track.
Do you got besides
Greenpeace following you?
Now it says Fat Sex Bagel again on the bad data.
All right, why don't we... all right, it's time. All right, you gave us the Man Cow demo. So what do you got?
Besides a yogurt cup full of mail. Sorry. We're running out of space.
I see. Just sat down.
Yeah, this is going to be a
load
ball.
Off. Tractor trailer. That's okay. All right. Come on, demo.
Yes.
What do you got?
What do you got?
The right. first track.
No. Why could he have nine toes?
Nine toes.
Oh, God. He doesn't have diabetes.
Not yet.
Yeah, he's
going to Not yet.
What do you got?
The Besides. First track. What do you The first track of the demo.
What demo? I forgot.
Man Cow's demo.
Man Cow, sure.
Oh, God.
That's funny. What?
Is it weird to talk about whose name fits your body? I could have done more with that, and I tripped on it.
Yeah.
It's okay. Okay. What about Man Cow, Boy Cow?
That's better.
Anything?
That's better.
That's right.
What do you got?
What do you got? Besides a stomach full of shame.
What do you got besides?
All right. The first track.
First track.
Holds a locomotive that is as heavy as me. No, I tease. That would no one's the size of a locomotive.
Yeah, but exaggerated humor is
a
smile.
It's a lot of fun.
Yeah.
And you did do a planet joke, so.
Yeah.
Were you upset that Alec Baldwin referred to his daughter as a rude you?
Right on you.
Right. Sorry, Hawk.
What do you got? Besides no self-control.
Oh
no, that's just mean-spirited.
Poor E-Rock.
Poor E-Rock. He's the best he can.
He does fine.
The first track.
With the little he's got.
First track. Of I know the next thing. Of the demo.
Yes.
Of the demo. Starts off with
an appetizer followed by soup, salad, and an entree of steak and mashed potatoes
and
desserts. Okay, sorry.
All right.
They come around, they say, would you like to see the dessert tray? He says, yes. And they say, we have cheesecake, tiramisu, and ice cream and creme brulee. And he says, I'll take it. He would love to punch me in the mouth right now.
Oh, I know.
And he'd probably knock me out.
Of course he would. He's working out.
Yeah, he would.
Like a white Buster Douglas.
What do you got?
All right.
Besides...
Not bad.
All right.
All right, go ahead.
What do you
got? Okay.
What do you got?
The first track of the demo starts off with...
What do you got besides... Wait a minute. I can't figure out how to say it.
Oh, all right. Oh, damn it.
What do you got for... Yeah, okay. What do you got besides
the first
a body that should be silhouetted before a Hitchcock film?
I'm not good.
Yeah, well.
Food makes the pain go away.
Oh, no. Wait, what are you talking about?
Aww.
What's the matter with you?
Sad.
Oh, what pain?
Okay. The first track.
What do you got besides?
Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no.
All right.
Anthony, what are you? I guarantee you, Anthony, right now is looking for a supportive clip.
Yes, I'm just thumbing through the templates looking for,
Something supportive and helpful?
Yeah.
Of course. So we have a demo, which I would like to get to.
Yeah. Iraq, if you would please.
Let me have a Diablo sandwich, a Dr. Pepper, make it fast. I'm in a goddamn hurry. Food, all right?
Eric.
Fried chicken! Fried chicken!
Was that the retard cook?
Pee-wee.
Fried chicken! Oh. Come on, everybody! Wake up! Rise and shine! Fried chicken!
Okay, all right. What do you got?
Morning, Mr. Breakfast! No, my health doesn't allow it.
Let's go to Dan in Albany. He's trying to help you out there.
Right? Welcome aboard.
Dan, what's up?
Hey, Iraq. I leave nothing on the table.
Oh. Oh, boy. Oh, that's not very nice. All right, so where were we? Yeah.
I tried to do the right thing, but I'm weak. I'm so fucking weak.
Let's go to Corinne. Corinne in Jersey, what's up?
Iraq, what do you got besides a girlfriend who's waiting for something better to come along?
Oh my God.
What type of way is that to talk to Eric?
None type.
Wow.
I'm sure his girlfriend is very happy.
Yes.
They live together, am I correct?
All right, let's go to Steve.
I'm sure she's in love with him.
Steve?
Vicky LaMotta didn't just leave Jake, did she?
Oh. Steve?
Hey, Rock, what do you got besides a closet full of increasingly longer belts?
I'm sorry I did that. I'm embarrassed that I did that.
All right, obviously, we take it as far as we can.
Yeah.
Including involving the listeners.
Yeah.
They're just going to say hurtful things. It's not the
way
to see
you. I know. It's not how I picture our show.
Faster. What? Go ahead, E-Rock.
Okay. Well, the first track on the demo.
What demo? I forgot. What
the Man Cow demo.
Yeah.
That he sent us, has him
Don't just stare at it. Eat it.
This just in from Chris the Gorilla from Atlanta. E-Rock's girlfriend tried to leave him, but she couldn't reach escape velocity.
Another planet reference. My God.
It's so hack, guys. Come on.
I know.
I love you, Johnny Cakes.
Loves those Johnny Cakes.
E-Rock, I'm sorry I started this whole thing before. My apologies. You know I'm a supporter.
Chester's liver from Whack Bag. What do you got besides an unused gym membership?
That was the sound his floor makes every morning.
I don't know.
I bring nothing to the table.
Is this on?
E-Rock's getting upset.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Look, he's yawning. Was that yawning or were you dislodging your jaw for another meal?
No, E-Rock, E-Rock. Oh, E-Rock, I'm sorry. No, I didn't want it to be me. Oh, no.
That's terrible. I'm sorry. That's terrible. I'm sorry.
E-Rock.
Oh, E-Rock, come on. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I apologize.
Yeah, bring him in. We got a caller that'll make him feel better.
E-Rock, I'm sorry. I apologize. I'm sorry. I will not play another clip, nor will I make another comment. Yeah. I apologize.
E-Rock, put the headphones on. We got someone that's going to make you feel better. Jay?
Oh. E-Rock, what do you got besides 40-inch waist and B cups?
Oh, that was just...
Hey, that's not what it said on the
that
screen.
That doesn't even... What? Stop it.
What happened?
I'm sorry.
All right.
Ted just asked if E-Rock was crying. He's not crying.
Oh. No.
Are you?
No. Oh. Somebody
gave
his report.
Oh, sweating maybe. His eyes are sweating.
Eyeballs can't sweat.
Tired of searching for food when there is none.
Don't. He's going to leave again. Stop it.
This is going to make
no
him.
More.
I'm going to try. This one will make him leave.
No.
I have no doubt in my mind. No. Here is the line of the day. Douglas from Salt Lake City. Instead of... Well, where'd it go? Oh, okay. Instead of push-ups, E-Rock should be doing throw-ups.
Oh, no.
No, see? Come on. The guy's in here to help
to
us intro the man-cow demo clips. Right. That's it. That's what we were doing.
All right.
All right. Let's get to those.
Just what? Watching your jaw. Jesus, that was a good one.
Ixnay. We'll all laugh at home during the replay. Yeah, don't worry, E-Rock. That'll only play three more times.
It won't make best of, I'm sure.
Yeah, this whole segment. It's timeless.
This will be played 5 years from now. It'll be thin as a rail. We'll still be playing this.
No, this will be considered the bit when he was skinny. No, no, E-Rock. I'm sorry. I'm kidding. E-Rock, I'm sorry.
Come on.
E-Rock, please come back.
There's
please
no crying.
Come back.
It's Chuck Jockery. Yeah.
No, and now he's going to the office. He's not even going to his computer. He's going around in Fez's office.
Oh, no.
Oh, E-Rock, I'm sorry. I apologize.
He went to ask for a job.
E-Rock, I'm sorry. Just come back. I won't say another one. I swear. I won't even utter another one. I didn't play a clip. I didn't play any clips.
Where is E-Rock?
No clips.
Come on, get him back in here.
Oh, no.
Get him back in here.
Jeez, that was a little mean.
Let's not be mean to the kid.
I'm sorry.
Where is he?
Lock.
Exactly.
I won't say another word.
Anthony's going to do what you couldn't. No. He's going to keep his lips closed.
Hey, we just came in.
He wasn't even sitting down yet. Come on.
Right. Snapman from Whackbag, what does E-Rock have besides a starring role in Norbit 2?
Oh, my. That isn't even funny.
That's just mean-spirited.
He's white.
Put your head
not,
on.
He's not that big.
All right.
Come on.
Sorry. Can I offer you a wafer thin mint?
All right, so where were we? Mancow, demo, clips.
Yeah.
Mancow's a douchebag.
Yeah.
Thought he's going to get all these stations, which he's not.
Yes, yes.
And has to send out a demo tape to these stations. And our station got one. Bunch of stations. He says people are calling him. Meanwhile, he's sending out, trying to get jobs. And no one's biting.
Corinne, remember Corinne? She really beat you up bad. She feels bad about that. So we got Corinne in Jersey. Corinne?
Eric, you really do bring something to the table.
See?
That's a shovel.
Okay, that wasn't.
Fat girls know all the insults.
Oh, no! No, you did it!
Balls exactly, back in that's your why court. Your girlfriend's dating you.
Oh, no!
Wait. That didn't even make sense.
How do you know what Corinne looks like?
She sounds fat.
Okay.
Did he invite her to the
Fair
station,
enough.
Too?
Fair enough.
No.
All right, Corinne.
She sounds
See, I got to shut up. I got such a good one.
What?
Do it.
What do you say? You got to...
No, I'm not saying it. Right. I'm being courteous to
right.
Iraq.
All right.
Well, funny.
Yeah, well, I mean, what were you saying? Like, what would you have said if you weren't being courteous? Like, because you are now, so you wouldn't say it. But he says she sounds fat.
She sounds fat. And I was like, why? Does it sound like the outgoing message on your machine?
Chester's liver from Whackbag.
But I wouldn't say that.
Absolutely.
Chester's liver from Whackbag.
Yes.
Speaking of man cow, come on in, E-Rock.
Come on.
That's not...
It's been done already. Yeah. It's,
I'm giving right, him
you
a
know,
line.
The man
the
cow
he wrote
thing.
It. He took the time from work. Yeah. Come on.
Let's hear a clip.
What is the pad day to say? It says a man cow demo tape, right?
Or fat sex bagel again.
No, we can't possibly. It has said that for two straight hours.
All right, let's go to George. George.
E-Rock, what do you have besides a blue ribbon from the county fair and a dead spider friend named Charlotte?
That's not. Oh. Isn't there a spider web with some producer written on it?
Will from Illinois. Will.
That's a Charlotte's
what
web.
What does E-Rock have besides a cock hidden by a thick layer of blubber?
So that was just a bit wrecking,
yeah.
Mean-spirited truth.
Let's say hi to Peter in Boston. Peter.
E-Rock. I tell you to turn the other cheek, but it'd probably take you a week and a half to get there.
That sounds like one of those, you know,
that's
snaps.
A, who
one
you,
of those
Ruth Bundy?
MTV
yeah,
fucking.
Let's don't go into the book.
Come on.
Let's not go
what
into
are you
the
doing
books.
Now?
No joke books.
Sam, why are you pointing out hurtful remarks?
It's a Frank Vincent reference.
Oh.
Well, instead of go get your shine box, it would be go get your lunchbox.
Go get your fucking lunchbox.
As a replay contributor guy. All right. Oh, yeah, words hurt. I forgot.
Words hurt. They do.
That's right.
Look, Eric's just sitting there waiting for this abuse to stop, and it's just not ending. This bus has more tires. Jesus.
Can we hear one of those clips that E-Rock?
Yeah, I kind of want to hear the clips
yeah,
now.
So
we should
I.
move on.
Yeah, let's play them.
Yeah.
All right, someone's really going to stick up for you. Wade in New York.
Hey, Wade.
Hey, what's going on, guys? Listen, at the Halloween party, I didn't have tickets, right? So E-Rock gives me two tickets as a favor. He says, next time you guys are busting his balls, to stick up for him. So here it goes, E-Rock. You're a great guy. You're going to lose that weight. Let it roll right off your back, all right? There you go. We're even. Later.
Oh, that is the greatest call ever.
That is a little backhanded.
You're a great guy. You're going to lose weight.
Did you
weight.
Really do that?
I don't think I did.
You probably did.
Let it roll off your back. We're even.
All right. So what are we doing?
We were doing Man Cow demo tape.
Mm-hmm.
I want to hear one of his... great bits that he's sending out to radio companies to try to have them hire him, mm-hmm. which they're not. And that's what I was saying. Howard doesn't send out demo tapes. We don't send out demo tapes. Come on. Than and Sam, no demo tapes there. We put them right on the air on Saturday, whenever the hell that is. Right?
Yeah.
Absolutely. When's the next one? You know?
Or, yeah.
Let it roll right off your back, but we don't have all day. That one was a write-in.
Yeah, that was a write-in.
Trying to be nice.
All right.
So
I have a soft spot for E-Rock.
Yeah, so do I.
All right, E-Rock. One for the world. It's called his belly.
No, I'm kidding. No, no, E-Rock, come on, come back. I'm kidding. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
How come Anthony keeps hurting
you? I do have a soft spot for you. Come on now.
Yeah,
come
why do you? Yeah, Anthony keeps hurting you.
I'm trying to. Me and E-Rock are good friends. We
drink
and stuff.
I haven't said a word about why.
It's fun.
Well, let's get him back in.
Just kidding.
All right.
Is it odd toasting beer and gravy?
It doesn't toast gravy. Now stop it. All right. The first track of the demo is Man Cow doing what, Ben?
Yeah, we forgot. The first track of the demo is Man Cow starting off everything by lying blatantly.
Ah, blatantly lying. Okay. That's what he does.
Who?
Man Cow.
Oh.
He lies a lot on the air. Lies. You are just trolling.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
We can hear it.
I'd like to hear it.
All right, here we go.
Okay.
Because it feels so empty without me.
Shut me down because I say it the way it is.
This looks like a job for me. So
all right. Just follow we are here.
Because we need a little controversy.
Welcome to Free Speech. Taking more calls than any other radio show in America. We want to give you a voice. 1-888-2-MAN-COW. I guess because, you know, the first day back in San Francisco here on a major powerhouse station, man. This is exciting. 100,000 watts. You ought to see the footprint on this thing. We basically cover. This is basically everyone in California is hearing us right now, so this is cool.
Awesome.
Jesus. That isn't even allowed. I think that was like Wolfman Jack did 100,000 watts from Mexico. That was pretty much it.
Is that how he got heard all over the country, right?
Yeah, yeah.
The station's logo for San Francisco says 50,000.
And what did he say?
100,000.
100,000.
Yeah. Pretty much most of the
AM.
Yeah. What else can we play for?
Ah.
He does a gay psychic bit.
Is it good?
No.
Why not?
Because he doesn't really tell, the person he has on doesn't really tell the future. They just tell you if you're gay or straight. And then you have to accept it. Second the answer, and he hangs up on you.
Yeah. Mariah, tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm a nurse. I've been married 3 times. My best friends are women. Uh-huh. And I just...
All right, Terry. Terry.
I'm getting... from Mariah, I'm getting that she's a lesbian. That she is she's in fact gay.
There you go, Mariah. You're a lesbian.
Yeah. I would relish it. I would go with it.
Do you have anything to say about that, Mariah?
Well, actually, I think I'm bisexual.
Oh, well, okay. There's no such thing, though, so you're a lesbian.
This is on his demo.
Yep.
Now this wasn't pulled because sometimes I'll tell you. Sometimes we pull audio that's really bad of somebody.
Shh, you're giving away our secrets.
It's not that it didn't exist. It's just really bad. But this is the best that he has culled from his program to put together as a representation of his show to send out to radio stations. So they can maybe consider him for employment. That's good stuff.
We got one more, maybe? Maybe that was just like a fluke.
Could have been.
What else you got there, Ira?
He does fake prank phone calls.
Want to give us a little more than that?
That's he has jingles leading into his fake prank phone calls announcing that it's a Man Cow phone scam.
Uh-huh. Ugh. Ugh. Jingles.
Phone scam time!
Hot damn, it's a Man Cow phone scam. Hot damn, it's a Man Cow phone scam. Turn it up, turn it up, turn it up, turn it up.
Holy shit.
Yes, is this the doctor's office?
Yes, it is.
Oh, thank God. You got to help me, Doc. You got to help me. I've got March Madness!
Oh, my God.
March Madness! Can you help me?
Yeah, come on over.
March Madness, help me!
Oh, God,
I got March Madness!
Come on over.
Woo!
March Madness.
He is just going to continue.
March Madness.
Holy fuck.
Kent, the movie guy from San Fran,
holy
Psycho.
Shit.
Wait, I know, I can't even. I can't even.
Fake phone calls, unlike all the real calls E-Rock makes to Domino's.
Now that's a stretch.
E-Rock,
come on.
We went 2 minutes without a laugh. I had to do it. That's the only reason I did that one. Wow.
That is so fucking bad with that bad intro, that like white man rap intro. Ugh. And then what was that prank? What was that? What the fuck was that?
I don't know.
Well, if a guy had... madness is typically a medical thing.
He had the March Madness, yeah, because of, you know, the college... yeah, basketball. I understand the March Madness part, but... Isn't a prank supposed to have a payoff or go somewhere or be funny at least somewhere? Yes, Dan?
Well, she kind of ruined it, too, because she's like, can I come in? She's like, yep.
Yep.
All right, bit over.
Yeah, I can come in. Yeah, March Madness.
And they used the same, come on in twice.
Yeah.
So they, like,
well, yep. You know what? You're probably being unfair. There's probably a good clip on there that you're not getting to because you're only playing one clip.
James from Saudi saying Man Cow could fill a major radio slot is like saying, oh, you're lucky this is fucking updated.
Oh, boy.
Oh,
it's had a long setup, too.
Oh, shit. Where did it go? It's like saying E-Rock could have a lean cuisine every now and then. It's just not going to happen.
Oh, no, that's...
Sorry, E-Rock.
I don't agree with that statement.
No. And now it's just getting old now.
Yeah, I think that you could trim up a little bit.
Vanilla Thunder from Philly. E-Rock wanted to hear that one clip. Because the word relish was in it.
that's
all right, do we have one more example while we're...
I hope so.
E-Rock,
you got the listing in front of you, the one right under it.
Mystery movie bit?
Yeah.
What's that
Mystery
about?
Mystery movie bit. Remember, this is the demo tape. This is the best he can gather to show this day. This is like your fucking... when you put together a resume... You want the best shit right there. And this is it.
What is it a bit about, seriously?
It's he plays a sound clip from a movie. You have to call in and guess and win a Man-Cow t-shirt.
Oh, God damn it.
All right.
Is he this delusional? He thinks fucking America wants to hear this crap?
Who cares?
Armando in Florida, hi.
Hi, how you doing?
Good, sir.
Armando.
Now, you think you know what the mystery movie is. What do you think it is?
I think it's Johnny Mnemonic.
Johnny Mnemonic is not right, sir. I'm sorry.
Oh, no. Come on, man. I've been relying on this all morning long, man. I knew it was. And it's not. I feel like killing myself, dude.
No, we'll give you the prize. 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 It's the wrong answer, but we'll act. No, dude. It's the wrong answer, but we're going to act like it's the right answer. Because I don't want you to... It's not worth... I'll give you this stupid Man-Cow shirt, dude. It's not worth killing yourself.
And now, the Man-Cow Mystery Movie.
Let's go to... I want to go to Armando in Florida.
So
Armando, what is it?
Johnny Mnemonic.
Yeah, that's right!
Yeah! Yay! Armando!
Good job!
Holy shit!
I don't know what to say to this.
Dude... If you're going to, like, set up a guy, make him believe he's going to kill himself, that guy said, I'm going to kill myself, like anyone would just say it.
Yeah.
As just a throwaway line.
Right.
And then he, with his bad acting...
Oh, no, no!
Make him believe that the guy actually is going to kill himself because he didn't win a t-shirt? Who the fuck is buying into this shit?
Apparently, nobody. Apparently, not a single person. This is horrible. Whew. What's the pad data say?
Man douche.
Oh, it does?
Congratulations. Eli.
You're off the pad data. Nice.
We can't go back to you after this. This is some unbelievable shit.
Good thing of the show.
What? Is there any others worth playing?
Yeah.
Only if there's... I think there might be one more highlighted. But
top of the hour celebration?
Oh, yeah.
What's this about?
every week at the top of the hour on a certain show, he has to play this one song all the time.
Every week.
At the top of the hour.
Top of the hour.
Where you would play a Legal ID or something.
Right.
He plays a song that's required once an hour.
Let's go to Mike in Florida. Mike?
Yeah, E-Rock's mystery movie bit would be The Blob.
We're trying to end with everybody happy in the studio.
You know how bad it is when you hear laughter through a soundproof window because they're fucking screaming in there laughing so hard? Oh, you know it's a bad joke.
Oh, here I. Wow. Sorry for the bonus time today.
It's just not fair to talk to him that way. The blob, that's disgusting.
Yeah, I did.
Granted, the last time we went bowling, he was freezing.
Ooh, movie reference. Yeah. All right. What else?
By the way, we don't hide behind lies. See, we're brave enough. Mancow thinks he's great at radio. We're showing everyone what his demo tape's all about. This is his actual demo tape that he's sending out to people. So this is what he thinks is the best of the stuff he does.
You know what? I would love the opportunity if I was in his shoes, where you don't really have a lot of stations, you don't have a lot of listeners, to be able to give the best material you have to a show that is nationally syndicated and have them play it. Imagine being able to do that. Put together your best of the best.
Yeah. Absolutely.
And that's what he did, and great stuff. Wow.
All right, so the celebration, top of the hour celebration?
He has to play a song once a week or once an hour?
From what I was hearing in the demo, he does it once a week, like one day a week. At the top of every hour, he plays this song.
All right, here we go.
Gentle, forgive me. This is Law. It is the top of the hour.
This is where DJ talks. Don't say anything.
Okay. Right. It's the Man Cow Show. This was the number one song in America, 1982. The McKenzie Brothers with Rush.
Beauty. Do you play the whole song? Yeah, you're fucking me, right?
No, he plays the whole song, but in the demo it blends into something else.
I bet you got that line for down the road.
You did realize what you said, right?
What the fuck? So you're fucking me, right?
Oh, you did. Okay.
All right, well. Yeah, well, you need that, of course. Like, there ain't 8,000 other lines that I've said.
I know.
There's been ones where it's just like, hey, yeah, hey, whip that cock out. Of course.
And why would you want that?
So I could... I'm not saying it. I'm not that stupid.
I know, you're not going to catch me saying I'm a cum guzzler.
Right.
Well, Joe from South Jersey, you guys don't hide behind lies, and E-Rock can't hide behind anything.
You're laughing. Come on. That's not nice.
That's just not right to laugh at Eric that way. It's just not right.
Oh, no, now you got a girl laughing at you.
That's
our friend,
nothing
Andrea.
Nothing more degrading.
That's Andrea. Didn't you used to have blonde hair?
Yeah.
What happened?
Anna Nicole died, and then you
wanted
to be like that.
Oh.
She's the cook. She's the official cake maker.
Right, yeah. That awful cake.
Yeah.
I'm not making any jokes.
No.
Tommy in New York has an E-Rock mystery movie. Tommy in New York, what's your E-Rock mystery movie?
E-Rock mystery movie, A Fridge Too Far.
A Fridge Too Far, is that it?
That's it. Punching out.
Wow.
Steel Tate from Baton Rouge. Rush? Something E-Rock never does.
Come on.
All right, that's really awful. So what do we got left here?
That was the hour. What was that called?
Well, how about the fighting with the hole over the Rosie bad parody song? Is that good?
It is so bad that we couldn't even highlight it on that.
Oh.
And what about the bad Irish PSA he does?
It's all fake production. They use corny... Irish parody names, and they're pretending to be drunk homeless guys.
Ugh. What's the Rosie thing, though? I like some kind of current topic.
They're arguing over, I guess, something Rosie said on The View.
Yeah.
And she's defending Rosie, and he's saying, oh, you're female. Of course you got to defend her. And then he plays a parody of that she eats a lot.
Let's hear that.
Oh, I bet the parody's awful. Why
don't you highlight it? Matt in Minnesota. Matt.
Hey, got one for E-Rock.
Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, words may hurt your feelings, but they won't hurt E-Rock's appetite.
All right, you know what?
Bit over.
What? Bit over. Bit officially over. Thank you.
Thank
we
you,
were
Matt.
Running a little
Absolutely.
Late. And I did want to get out of here relatively early. College student kills one, wounds two near Fresno State. Okay.
I think it's Caltech, right?
Great. There you go.
Shooting at Caltech. Great.
That's wonderful.
Line of the day brought to you by Nobody. Everyone gets one.
Wow.
There's six runners up.
Oh, we're never getting out of here.
Six runners up today. Wow. What a hysterical show this is. I'm sure they start at like 6 a.m. and go all the way until probably 5 minutes ago and haven't been just the past, hour and a half.
All right, here we go. A runner-up line of the day.
Let's hear.
This will be played 5 years from now. It'll be thin as a rail. We'll still be playing this.
No, this will be considered the bit when he was skinny.
Wow.
Ah, that was terrible. I apologize.
All right, another runner-up line of the day.
Oh, okay. Look, he's yawning. Was that yawning, or were you dislodging your jaw for another meal?
All right, that's right. They're not leaving in the part where he left after every one of these.
That's all right. That's okay.
It's okay. Here's another runner-up line of the day.
The first track.
What do you got besides
Greenpeace following you?
A wailing joke, of course.
Yeah,
that's very nice.
Hurtful.
Got to get a couple of those in there.
Sure.
Another runner-up line of the day.
He's going to walk in one day, and Sam and Danny are just going to revolve around him.
Wow.
My apologies, Eric.
Eric, take the rest of the day off. It's okay. Just go.
He had to sit through all these ones.
Absolutely. Would have stood if he could have.
Another runner-up line of the day?
I think that was it. He had to sit through these. He would have stood if he could.
I missed it, but I got
Holy
it
Holy shit, Jimmy. And then he got a water bottle thrown at him by E-Rock.
Are we adding another runner-up line of the day?
No.
No, you sure?
Yeah.
All right. Here's another runner-up line of the day. What do you got, E-Rock?
The very first track of this...
What did you say?
50 pounds too much weight, right?
Yeah, that was about 50 pounds too much.
I'm sorry. I can't stop.
Oh. Or what do you got besides cranky shoes?
And high cholesterol.
Jesus, that was a three-banger.
Wow.
I should let you have it. That was like
no,
way
that was
good.
Just nasty.
Very good. Another runner-up line of the day? All right, one more, wow. I think.
You went to market, and you had to have some roast beef, and then you wee-wee-weezed all the way home.
I didn't catch the wee-wee-weezed all the way home the first time,
That's
Jim.
That's brilliant. Jim Norton, Caroline's all weekend long, Thursday through Sunday. And tickets for the ONA Traveling Pirates Comedy Show.
Yes, Ticketmaster.com.
Come on.
Ticket prices will be going way up after Friday. line of the day? Line of the day.
Here comes line of the day. Line of the day.
I don't exercise enough.
Cock meat. Nothing but cock meat. What the?
New tag.
New tag.
Where did you get the new tag from?
Is that Steve?
Of course it was Steve. Who else would sing cock meat?
I know. That was actually his subconscious.
I don't even know what that was.
Oh, somebody God. Asked you what you wanted for lunch.
Oh, shit.
What the fuck?
What was that?
Probably in Derek's studio cutting something and unaware that the fucking microphone was on again and punchy and singing.
You know what, and does Derek save all our flubs?
Yeah.
He should put a best of flubs together for the show.
I got plenty of them.
I got ridiculous ones.
Yeah. Yeah.
Just us already fucking up copy and all that.
Already in the works. Just bleep out.
Bring
the,
it to the show.
Bleep
soon.
Out the sponsor names.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's all you got to do.
You got it, Derek? You should bring some of that in soon.
Yeah.
Bring in some of the best of the crap we do in there. Because he usually gets us tired and it's just... It's,
oh, I know.
All right. We got to go. E-Rock,
was that was great. A lot of fun today.
E-Rock, thanks for being fat.
Oh, that's, I thought you were going to say being a good sport.
Eric was a very good sport today.
It gave us an hour, so I really appreciate the fact that you have no self-control.
Well, my apologies. The hurtful lines I said, I apologize.
Oh, look at me. He killed you way more than I did.
No, I didn't.
Aw, Jimmy, he
I'm
kissed
very,
you.
I'm very nice to E-Rock. Well, he was going to eat me, but people were watching.
There he goes. Now go spin through some Midwestern town.
Poor E-Rock. he's feeling kind of low.
Spin to a Midwestern town like the Tornado Doughboy. It's a stretch, but it works. I just wanted to poke his stomach, watch him go.
Can I hear the cock meat clip again?
I'm trying to work it in.
Yeah, let me hear it. Cock meat. Nothing but cock meat.
Steve, what the fuck?
Oh, what an asshole.
Hey, Steve, what diet are you on right now?
Aren't cock
you?
Meat.
Oh.
Nothing but cock meat.
Ah, okay.
Boy, it's good. To confuse the issue with everybody.
My God.
Asshole.
That's good.
Hey, how do you like to introduce somebody to your mouth?
Cock meat. Nothing but cock meat.
Besides the toilet paper, what do you put in your ass?
Cock meat. Nothing but cock meat.
E-Rock, this is going to save you. This is the last thing people are going to remember until tomorrow.
That's how it works. You know what I can't stand? When you're in a hotel and you don't bring a toothbrush with you. Steve, what do you use?
Cock meat. Nothing but cock meat.
Fucking Steve. Why would you say that?
Oh, my God.
That is fantastic.
I don't really. I honestly don't know.
No, we do know.
Oh. That one is right here. That has to be right there. Next to the rest of my Steve clips.
No, nothing's wrong. Just stay in the living room. I'll handle it.
Cock meat. Nothing but cock meat.
Is there any more to that song?
I don't think so. I hope not.
Wow.
God, I hope. I really hope not.
Oh, shit.
All right. Well, I guess
that's good. Cock meat.
Nothing but.
Yeah.
Not even the head or the balls, but the meat of it.
He just wants, like, the prime rib of the cock.
Like, you ever have crab cocktail? It's just a bunch of pieces of crab. What's the meat of the cock? The fat, veiny part. You could take the head is for the birds, as Steve will frequently blog. The head has no nutritional value. It isn't chewy enough. You eat the head, kid. I'll have the meat.
I just want the meat. That's it.
Yeah.
Would
cock
you like
meat. Nothing but cock meat.
So, sir, are you saying you don't want head or balls with that?
Cock meat.
Okay.
Nothing but cock meat.
That's right. Appetizer or salad?
Cock meat. Nothing but cock meat.
All right. And any dessert or coffee afterwards?
Cock meat.
Okay, sure.
Nothing but cock meat.
I'll have that right out for you.
Well,
oh, God.
Until now, Rice-A-Roni was the San Francisco treat.
People want this for their ringtone, by the way.
Oh, who doesn't? Imagine you're in the train and your phone rings and you hear this.
Cock meat.
Who could it be?
Nothing but
cock meat.
Oh, hello.
You hear 30 people in a row just going, Steve?
Steve.
Matt from Queensbury.
Queensbury, check it in.
Yeah.
We got to acknowledge Canada.
This is obscure reference. Very good. Steve, what do you usually have in your hand in the dressing room at Lane Bryant?
Cock meat. Nothing but cock meat.
Yeah.
He remembers what Steve used to wear as the lead singer of
Foundry.
Of Foundry, yeah.
And he was playing
singing Pendulum.
Pendulum.
Singing Pendulum.
What did that pendulum slice up?
Cock meat. Nothing but cock meat.
Love it.
Yeah, right.
Well, can we go home now?
Yeah. Why don't we just leave? What does the pad data say, by the way?
Steve C.
Just as Steve C.
But it might as well say.
Yeah, might as well. Cock meat. Nothing but cock meat.
Steve cock
meat. All right.
And people are trying to bring E-Rock back into this now.
No, there's no need for that.
This stands on its own.
Absolutely.
It's, we've moved on to
E-Rock
bigger and better
things. E-Rock doesn't like eating cock meat, I'm sorry.
No, no.
That's the only thing he doesn't like eating.
No.
Of course not, it's low fat.
Whose phone's ringing?
Someone's phone is ringing? Or oh, is that out there?
All right. Ron Fez up in, only 20 minutes of this.
People are wondering, what does the C stand for in Steve C?
Cock meat. Nothing but cock meat.
Ah, okay.
All right. Steve cock meat.
It's coming in like crazy. Could you just do, get Steve a mic. Could you sing E-Rock's version of this song? That would have, of course, be lunch meat. It's coming in way too many times. Just give us a lunch meat.
All right. Is it on?
Yeah, it is.
So, lunch meat. Lunch meat. Nothing but lunch meat.
The way that left hand kind of kept time by going in and out.
You like that?
No, I want to slice it off.
Here you go.
Did you do that hand motion with the cock meat version?
I think I did. I'm really afraid that Derek is going to find some other piece of that song that I completely
more?
Forgot that I did.
Derek,
I hope so.
If Derek wants to continue working here, he better find it.
Look at him go. He's out of the room.
I have been in that studio punchy and completely unaware of what I'm saying into a microphone so many times.
Ooh. Oh, but we're aware.
Yeah. Oh, here we go.
All right, let's go home.
We're done.
I want to go home.
Thanks, guys. Ron and Fez up at noon. Office.
Yes. Check out Ron and Fez.
And tomorrow, do we have anybody tomorrow? What, tomorrow's Wednesday. I thought we had somebody.
Starving there, Earl. We got any cock meat back there?
Oh, cool. We got Larry the Cable Guy, 8 o'clock.
Larry the Cable Guy.
Very good. I'm happy about that.
Yeah, very cool. Whatever.
All right. Dunsky. Just shut everything down. I'm out. Feeling a little hungry. Anyone want to go to lunch, maybe? Steve, you got a hankering for anything?
Cock meat. Nothing but cock meat.
Right. I'm done.
Yeah.
Gotta be quick. I got to go to the audio.
Okay. I'm going.
All right.
What we got?
What are we talking about today, meeting-wise?
Meeting.
What?
Meeting?
Cock meat.
Ing.
Nothing but cock meat. Ing.